I think it's an amazing exhibit and an incredible artifacts and a piece of history that I'm so glad that we're able to share with the public. Well, I think it's important for young people to see not just what we did, but by looking at some of these, the spacecraft and some of the, you know, the spacesuits and the various other things in the exhibit, they're going to see that, you know, this is not high tech by their standards at all, right? They say that that your car fob has more technology, computing technology than the Apollo spacecraft. And that's a hard thing to understand when you've grown up with cell phones and iPads and all of those things. So I think it'll be a really an eye-opener for them, and I hope that they internalize it and are inspired to come up with new inventions that will take us, you know, beyond the moon. It's really wonderful, right? Because Cincinnati's where my mom and dad chose to settle after my father retired from NASA. And I know my father was always a big supporter. Both of my parents were big supporters of the Cincinnati Museum of Natural History then, and later the Cincinnati Museum Center. So it's appropriate, it's perfect, and I couldn't think of it any other way. Bok is very special. Mostly because that speech that my father gave showed his creative side. You know, he's really well known for being an engineer and a test pilot and being unflappable and all these things. But there was another side to his personality that was very whimsical, and that really comes across in that Bok the Rock speech.